During one of my daily Wikipedia surfing sessions, I stumbled upon a peculiar molecule, which was apparently supposed to smell and taste like an artificial banana flavor. And with people like NileRed basically turning everything into sodas, I wanted to try my hand at making something similar. However, the main difference is that NileRed has an actual lab and clean glassware, while I'm doing this in my crack shed with glassware that previously had stuff like mercury, bromine, liquid cancer, and much, much more. So the artificial banana flavor I'm talking about is isoamyl acetate, which is a compound that is used to confer banana or pear flavor in foods such as circus peanuts, juicy fruit and pear drops. And what you really need to make it is some isoamyl alcohol and some vinegar. For isoamyl alcohol, I've just bought heather vinegar, or acetic acid as it is actually called, needs to be concentrated to around 100%. And to do that before filming, I've got some vinegar and I've done some chemistry magic to turn it into sodium acetate, which is a salt of acetic acid. This acetate was then thrown into an oven to dry, to dehydrate it completely. And now what we're going to be doing is adding one of the strongest acids in the world to turn the sodium acetate back into acetic acid. And since by that point all of the extra water will be gone, it will be called glacial acetic acid. First to the flask, I've added 50 grams of sodium acetate, then I've added 75 mL of concentrated sulfuric acid. Also, this sulfuric acid is actually licensed. As the sulfuric acid touches the sodium acetate, a vigorous reaction occurs. Because sulfuric acid is stronger than acetic acid, it has the power to displace the acetate ions and jump on the acetate group's place, taking the sodium ion in. Once that happens, the acetate ions are stuck with only hydrogen ions, which are basically the island boys of the periodic table, and everyone wants to get rid of them. That's also why acids exist anyway. It's all because of hydrogen. As I said, the reaction is vigorous and acid literally boils the solution, and the whole apparatus has to be closed very quick to not release too much acid vapor. Just look how angry it is, Jesus. Now we can go into the proper segment of this, which is the distillation. As the solution gets boiled, the vapor condenses in the condenser into a liquid and it drips down into the beaker. Because there is still some water in the system, and this water will most likely form an isotrope with acetic acid and get boiled down first, I'll be throwing out the first fraction. I don't have a thermometer, so this is kind of like doing surgery blindfolded, but I don't care because I'm a gangster. Here's me smelling the distillate.
It's concentrated.
Eventually, for whatever reason, the whole thing turns brown, and that's just organic chemistry, okay? It tends to do random stuff with no explanation like this. This is also why it was invented by the spawn of H.P. Lovecraft. Totally not this guy. Anyway, this is around 20 mL of our glacial acetic acid, and it's just enough for the reaction. This is some isoamyl alcohol that I've ordered from the car stealers, and now it's ready to be bananified. Anyway, to a 250 ml boiling flask, I've added all the glacial acetic acid. Then around 60 mL of isoamyl alcohol. And finally a stir bar. Now technically, if organic chemistry wasn't dark magic of Satan, then we would technically be able to just add this and wait for the isoamyl acetate to teleport from a parallel dimension. However, this is sadly not how organic chemistry works, and we're gonna need a strong acid catalyst. And for that, I've asked my homie sulfuric acid to help. And I've started drop-wise adding 4 mL of concentrated sulfuric acid. Now we're ready to start a reflux. A reflux is basically when you boil the solution without the loss of any liquids. Anyway, I've cranked up the heat and eventually the solution began to vigorously boil. You can see by the droplets here that the condenser column is working, and to be honest, I couldn't wait to taste the banana soda. What we're carrying out here is a Fischer esterification reaction. Fischer esterification is the esterification of a carboxylic acid by heating it with an alcohol in the presence of a strong acid. Fischer esterification is an example of a nucleophilic alkyl substitution based on the electrophilicity of the carbonyl carbon and the nucleophilicity of an alcohol, which increases the electrophilicity, whatever that means, of the carbonyl carbon. Then the dark magic of Satan's organic chemistry attacks the nucleophilic oxygen of the alcohol, after which a proton transfer occurs, then a protonation, and the loss of water gives us an ester, in our case isoamyl acetate, and I'm totally not reading it straight from Wikipedia. The problem with Fischer esterifications, which I'm about to find out, is that they take a long time, and I should have left it for longer to react. Also, I really should have used the heating mantle, but oh well. So anyway, I've left it to react for like 30 minutes, and then I went to play some Fortnite, and playing Fortnite was a mistake, not only for my social life, but for this experiment. Mostly because I thought that the column would be able to hold out without cooling water. However, I guess I was wrong. The condensing column eventually got overwhelmed and suddenly a bunch of steam was coming off the top. Then couldn't really attach any cooling water because this condenser's tubing enter was broken. So anyway, I've stopped the reflux and eventually I've realized that all of this was a failure. However, for some reason I decided to keep going and I've tried to do the extraction. And eventually I've started using diethyl ether for some reason, and after evaporating the ether there was nothing left. So I just cried myself to sleep that night. Also, while I was decanting the diethyl ether layer, a giant bug just thrown itself into the open window of my lab and catapulted itself onto my table. I did get scared, however, I guess jokes on him, because there was enough diethyl ether in the air to put down a small pitbull. Anyway, I've just repeated the whole thing. I've done the same thing along with the distillation and the reflux. This time though, in the reflux, I've used some cooling water and you can see on the video how the vapor travels inside the condenser. All of that white stuff is literally all of the vapors from the reaction, which are getting cooled back down into a liquid. So the whole mixture from the boiling flask was added into a separatory funnel, and on top of it there is a small layer. This layer is the isoamyl acetate layer, and I can already smell this strange, strong smell, which actually smells kinda fruity. So I started decanting the lower water layer, and I have to really slowly, because the organic layer is extremely small. Once most of the water layer is decanted, a very small line appears, which is where the isoamyl acetate separated. I've got most of the water layer out, so now I can transfer everything into the test tube. Anyway, this is all of our isoamyl acetate. It's extremely small, and if you want to attempt this, I recommend leaving the reflux for much longer and up the temperature a bit more, because Fischer esterification is a really long process. Anyway, if you watch my videos, you may recognize that this is literally the same test tube which I've used for the liquid cancer video, which had a bunch of not only corrosive bromine and also 1,2-dibromoethane, which is an extremely carcinogenic compound, and probably some organic bromides which are just straight up toxic. So if I suddenly stop uploading, well, just know that no one is getting my Fortnite account after I die of liver failure. Anyway, I've pipetted off the water, now this is our product. Anyway, here's me huffing the oil. And for that, I've literally put the whole test tube inside my nostril.
Oh. Shit. It smells really sweet. And you don't mix it with water, but just straight up inhale it. It kind of smells like fermented stuff.
So here's the obligatory taste test of the banana oil, and I guess I see in a few months if I got cancer.
Let's go. Shit. It's kind of like a little bit of sugary water. It's kind of sweet, but I'm going to rinse off my mouth now.
Well, I guess I didn't like it at the time, and that's mostly because it was extremely concentrated, so let's see how it will taste when I banana sodify it. So anyway, this is my first time making a soda, and also this is a licensed recipe, so don't even think about stealing it from me. First I've added a shit ton of sugar, then I've topped it out with a bunch of fizzing water. I don't really have a soda stream, which is quite unfortunate. Then I've added all of the banana flavor.
The secret ingredient.
I didn't really have a recipe for this, however, I probably should have pipetted just a few drops into it. But, oh well. Anyway, here's me taste testing it.
So, this is it. It doesn't have the color, I know, but hopefully it will taste good. Right, so let's... Oh wait, the gloves. You know, many people say that I don't wear gloves enough, which is completely untrue.
And aluminum sulfur. And here's me mix. This video, I'll be making chlorine part was drained in the calcium.
So, to humor you for the most dangerous process, which is tasting, because you have to wear gloves at all times. Alright, so here we go. Please don't separate. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Fuck. I didn't spit it out because it sucked, but Jesus Christ, the smell is so uncanny. I think I've added way too much of that banana extract or something. Jesus Christ, I need some water. This tastes so weird.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Make sure to like and subscribe if you like the video.